Now we get to take this apart. See how we do. I took this off yesterday and inspected it, see how we were doing, put it back under the clamp again. So some of you may notice that I have two pieces of wax paper here instead of the saran wrap that was on there. And this looks not too bad. One way of checking this, and put it on your table saw and see how flat it is. Not too bad, pretty good. Now, the reason for putting those edges on that tape, so you can very easily get hold of it, peel it off at an angle. So we're gonna take our plywood and run one side through the planer, reduce the thickness to the same as the two inside layers. And we have a sheet of wood here that's got nice tight grain pattern on it. Would be attractive for a gear, one of our wood gear clocks. So we'll glue that up, put it back in the press, and when it comes out, we'll reduce both of those outside layers to the same thickness as the others. And we'll end up with a five-layer symmetrical piece of wood. Symmetrical in the sense that the two outside layers, the grain direction, will be facing the same way. And hopefully that'll be stable and will be good for our clock. So Murphy is alive and well and lives in my shop today. The camera quit in the middle of the planing. So most of this I've already done. I only have like one more pass to go through the planer. You didn't miss anything. It's just a lot of noise. So we'll try it again. So the outside ply is under 60 thousandths. The total thickness of the three plies together is about 0.177, so that's pretty good. And we're gonna leave it at that. And we'll go over to the gluing jig and do the final glue up. We put quite a bit of moisture into this wood yesterday using that water-based glue, and it really hasn't had a chance to dry out. We don't want things to start warping, so we need to finish this project straight away. This is not something you want to put on the shelf and come back to in a couple of days. One of the reasons for leaving this outside layer thick is that this is really quite a rigid piece now. And we're going to put that down. We're going to lay our last sheet on top of it. This last sheet has a little curvature to it. We want to face that down, put that center curve up, and make sure that we get the wood grain in the correct direction. Okay, I'm going to turn that over right now before I forget which way that goes. These rollers are not terribly expensive. If you're going to do this, it's a pretty good investment. This morning I pulled our piece of homemade plywood out of the press. Looks pretty good. And set it on here. Press it around and see that it's pretty flat in both directions. So when we're done, it's about 0.28. 0.27. That's close enough. Here we've taken our paper pattern for the Simplicity third wheel and we've glued it to our 5-ply homemade plywood. Cut out the circle, sanded the edges. Now we're ready to cut out the internal parts of the wheel and all of the teeth. And when we get done, we'll have something that looks like this. And you take a heat gun and you can heat up this pattern and peel it off and clean up the surface, and you'll be ready for the next wheel. It's a lot of work to make all of the plies for a piece of plywood. One possible shortcut, might even be a better approach, would be, we know that Baltic birch is stable. Take for a quarter inch, you take off the two outside layers, or a half inch, we could take off one layer from either side or two layers from either side, then laminate the thin wood that we've created to either side, put it in the press and clamp it up. That would save a lot of time.